and celebrate singing her birthday tonight. Somebody celebrating her birthday tonight. Let's wish Rose a happy birthday.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, what's your name, please?
My name is Hannah, but on stage they call me Lioness.
On stage, what do you mean by on stage?
On stage, because I am a singer, and when on stage, I have a stage name, and it is Lioness.
So, are you a reggae singer or what?
Yes, I am a singer. I am a singer.
Reggae?
I sing all types of music, because when I started singing, I was involved in a band which is open to every music, you know, from reggae, afro, international. So for me, my recordings are based on all types of music. That's why my group is called Africa, and I'm confined music because we have that influence of every type of music.
When do you start your career?
I didn't start my career in 1999. That's when I started my career, my journey of singing.
And where do you live?
I live in Italy at the moment. I am based in Italy, the land of love, amore.
Are you an engaged musician?
Yes, I am.
Okay, talking of engaged, we are going to talk a little bit about your country, Kenya.
Yeah.
Well, you know what's happening now.
Yeah.
What is your opinion about it?
My opinion is spreading peace, love, and unity. That's why I composed a song called Amani Upendo Moja, meaning peace, love, and unity. Because that's what we need. You know, without that, whatever is happening in Kenya, we cannot go on ahead like this without love, and without peace, and without unity among ourselves in Kenya. So, I am spreading the message. Peace, love, and unity in Kenya. That's what we need first. You know, apart from the violence, the elections, presidential choices, everybody has a choice to make. But at the end of the day, we need the peace, love, and unity in Kenya. You know, because we cannot live without that. We can make our choices, you know. We can make our choices, but if we don't have the peace, love, and unity in ourselves, then between us, the citizens of Kenya,
okay,
we cannot be living.
Okay, we will come back on it.
All right.
You were invited to perform tonight. How do you come across these people? How do they come to invite
all right,
you?
I came across these people through the Facebook. You know, Facebook has become a universal thing, you know? Universal thing. And, you know, I communicated with one, I saw the event, I communicated with Sara Muller, and I got the chance to be here tonight, right? It's the best night. The people have been happy. You know, we've had a very splendid time tonight. You know, Mashujaa Night Special for Kenyans. You know, we celebrated the Mashujaa Night Special, and everything has been okay.
Is your first time to perform in Switzerland?
First time in Zurich. I had a chance in Bill. We call it Bill. I had a chance years back in Bill. And this is my second time in Switzerland. And I also made tonight, I was so happy to meet my first promoter who brought me Bill in Switzerland. Yes,
we got it on. As an experienced musician, do you have a release on the market?
Yes, we have a lot of on iTunes. If you go and look for us, Africa, that is A-F-R-E-E-K-A. We are on iTunes. We have our songs on iTunes. And we have
When you mean we, you belong to a band?
Yeah, I'm meaning me, we are a duo. Africa is a duo. Me and Henry Harrison. And Henry Harrison is a very is a very special, talented person because he...
Is it your partner? That's
my husband.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
That's my husband. And he is the son of the legendary Teddy Kalanda Harrison of the Mushrooms, the most...
So you are, musician...
Precious band in Kenya.
Musician couple.
Yeah, we're a musician couple.
Yeah.
But music is music. And couple comes couple. So in music.
So we're gonna laugh a little bit. When you fight, you fight for instance, you and
no,
he.
When
when it's come to fight, and you have a show, how do you manage that?
No, we keep personal things aside.
Yeah.
And music is music. Also we can fight in music.
Yeah, no. When you fight in your house, I mean in your room or living room, and you have a show, how do you make it?
No, we do make it. At the end of the day, we have to go on stage and we have to go.
That's funny, huh?
We have to.
It happened already.
Yeah, it happens every
time. That's good.
It happens every time.
Yeah.
It happens every time. But we do make it on stage.
Yeah.
When we reach the stage, we pop.
Yeah.
Today. You know, when like Bob Marley says, when music hits you, you feel okay.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah,
okay.
When we hear the music, we feel okay and we forget about it.
Okay, so, I mean, what is your future?
My future.
In musically talking.
My future, I want to, I've been here in Europe for 11 years now, all right? My future here, I want to stabilize my future here in Europe. You know, because I believe that I have made a foundation here in Europe. So my point is, I want to get Europe. You know, as an artist based in Europe, you know, I have the rights also to conquer Europe. You understand what I'm saying? And you know. Every time we see artists from Africa, they're being invited here to the show, and they're being paid a lot of money. I'm here in Europe, you know? I want to conquer Europe. I want people to know my music, you know? Why can't you pay me also? You know, I'm not talking about that big money, but
As engaged musician, what is your impression about African nation nowadays?
No, African nation, you know, we have a lot to think about. You know, these things I've been saying so much years before. I'm a young person right now, you know, but we need Africa to come up. Africa, I don't know what can make us wake up and understand the situation that is here in Europe for us Africans. You know, I see Africans every day. You know, I will tell you one thing. Like also me, I do a translation. I'm a translator in the immigration in Italy. You know?
Okay, talking of immigration.
Yes, sir.
That is the right point because, you know, for my question.
Yeah.
Talking of immigration.
Yeah.
What do you think about this immigration of African youth?
Well, I will say this. You know, immigration before was better for us Africans. But right now, immigration is not what we are thinking of. We come here, it's not what we think, that we're going to find gold inside here. There is no gold for us inside here. You understand? We cannot, we don't have gold here. What we have is the sufferings we suffer here in Europe. You know, getting jobs. First of all, I will tell you, I can give you a small process, all right? You come in Europe, you know, you leave everything in Africa. You come in Europe, you will lose 2 years, maybe 3 years of your documentation because you need the documentation for you to work, yeah? For you to work. So you have 3 years. You're just on the run. You don't know what to do. You understand what I'm saying? So, it's better for us Africans to be valuable to ourselves in Africa. before coming to you. I am here 11 years, and I'm still on the run. I will tell you. And I want to be a testimony.
But do you think that the African young, they still have hope in Africa with what is happening?
I know.
Or the politician, what they are doing, you know, all those things.
It's a sad story in Africa. Whatever is happening in Africa, in every country in Africa, it's a very sad story. I know that. But if I always say the project is we ourselves. Wherever you are the project. Make yourself a project of your life. Understand? Of your life. I know what is happening. I know. It's so. The situation in Africa is so down for us. We don't have hope anymore. But I will tell you, in Europe, hope can be there, but I have a quote. Only the strong survive in Europe. Only the strong survive. For me, I've been the strongest here to be here. Okay? I cannot advise anybody to come in Europe. That you can make it, you can make millions. 11 years, I'm still trying to make it up. Okay? So Africa, our leaders, our people, we have to come together and think about this thing. Because there's one European man who said, before we used to go in Africa and bring the slaves in Africa, in Europe, but now the slaves are coming by themselves. That is not a good quote. You know, before they went to Africa to bring the slaves, you know, to Europe. But now we Africans, we come ourselves to Europe and we be slaves. Tell me about it.
I think you have a special message for the two leaders in Kenya, because I think personally that the people of Kenya, their brothers and sisters, they do not have problems.
Yeah.
The problem belongs to politicians. Do you have a word for these people?
I have a word. The problem we have in Kenya, we have become so tribal. We have so many tribes in Kenya, I know that. But I don't understand why we have two tribes that we should be so tribal about in Kenya. That we should be so messy and bring no peace among ourselves, you know. We wake up with no peace. We think no peace, you understand, in Kenya. But I think we can, whatever is going on, I know, I understand. And we just have the peace, you know, the peace among ourselves. That's all. That's all I can say about Kenya. We just need the peace. I am Kenyan. You can see that. I am Kenyan. You can see that. We just need peace.
So what is your name again?
My name is Hannah.
Hannah.
Called me Hannah originally. Mama named me Hannah. My stage name is Lioness because I roll. I'm the queen of the jungle.
And it was a pleasure for us to meet Anna.
I'm so grateful.
You play reggae, right?
I play reggae, I play afro, I play world music. I'm all...
Okay, it was nice to meet you somewhere in Zurich.
I appreciate it.
Somewhere in Zurich. At Ellen Köhler-Strasse in Zurich. This place is called Ellen Köhler.
This is Masuja Night Special for the Kenyan people.
And we hope to meet you again to talk.
Yeah.
International affairs.
All right.
That was Nambo Banao for Communication 1G from Zurich.
Yeah.
Greetings.
Greetings.